Hello and welcome to the Batfish Enterprise Sandbox. In this demo, I will show you how you can test and validate the changes you want to make to your network and get assurance that those changes are safe and will not cause a network outage. I will do this demo over this data center network, which has multiple pods. It's got a routing fabric that connects the pods, and it has a data center interconnectivity layer that connects to the internet and to other data centers. Within the data center, we are running BGP in parts of it, and we are running OSPF in other parts of it, and the routing fabric comes together via redistribution between these two protocols. All the information that I'm showing you has been derived by Batfish using just the configuration files of devices, so it can figure out which devices are connected via BGP, which ones via OSPF, and which ones have links in between them. The change I will focus on is bringing a device down for maintenance. In particular, I want to check whether bringing down this device here, DSR001B, is safe or not. As you can see from the connectivity, that the network has redundancy built in, and when I bring down DSR001B, DSR001A should be able to carry its traffic. But I want to make sure that this actually happens. So here's how I'll do it. I go to the sandbox tab here. I click on the device I want to bring down. The sandbox will give me two options at the top. One is I can do a cost out procedure of the device by changing its configuration, so by changing its OSPF cost or its BGP routing policies, or I can simply deactivate the node. Deactivation mimics a situation where the device's power has been directly pulled instead of its configuration being changed. So to keep it simple, I will just use the deactivation method. I will apply these changes and I will give a snapshot a name. What I have basically done is created a proposed snapshot for my network that Batfish will comprehensively analyze for correctness and safety. And there are multiple ways to do that. Via the Explore tab, you can interactively check whether this snapshot is doing what you expect it to do by running, for instance, virtual traceroutes. On the Policy tab, you can check whether this new snapshot meets all of the policies that you have set up for your network. But in this demo, I will focus on the Compare tab. The Compare tab compares the snapshot you have created, DSR Mint, with a reference snapshot, the original master I had, and it shows you all the ways in which the network will behave differently if this snapshot were to be pushed to the network. And we categorize these differences along multiple classes, so you can see configuration difference. So in this case, there was no difference in the configuration, device properties, interface properties, and routing protocols. It also shows you how the ribs in the network will differ if once the snapshot takes effect. So in this case, it's showing that on this router, core 001B, 4 prefixes will be updated and 10 prefixes will be removed. So I can take a look at these differences and see somewhat expected that a next hop DSR001B has gone away from this node for many of the prefixes in the network. One of my favorite views on the comparison tab is this reachability matrix. What this shows is that for all possible sources in the network and all possible destinations in the network, if there are flows that will be removed, that is, they will no longer be carried by the proposed snapshot compared to the reference, or if there are flows that will be added. So sometimes new traffic may be added, for instance, if you're making a firewall change. And what we are seeing here is that this change is not safe because there are a whole bunch of flows denoted by this yellow here that the network will stop carrying if we were to make the change that I just proposed. In particular, from all these sources to all these destinations, some flows will not be carried, and we can look even at the details of the flows that will stop being carried. Similarly, from these sources here to all these destinations, flows will not be carried. So clearly this is showing me that it is not safe to bring down DSR001B for maintenance. So the question is, why is that happening? From here we observe that all of these devices here are actually in this part of the network. So FinApp has been disconnected, XSW001A and XSW001B has been disconnected. This basically gives me a hint that perhaps the routing configuration on XSW is not correct. So to see what's really going on and to figure out whether what change I can make to this configuration such that bringing down DSR001B becomes safe again, I will go to its configuration. So I want to see what's really happening for the routing between this device and DSR. So I see here that this device connects to DSR001A on an interface 0045. So what I really want to check now is what's really happening in the routing configuration. So say, okay, this is running OSPF. So that looks all good. So interface type PDP, that's good. Oh, wow. So I'm actually running mistakenly OSPF in passive mode on this interface, which is clearly not my intent because I want the traffic to fail over. Now what I can do right in the sandbox, I want to see whether if I were to delete this line or change this configuration in this way, is it then safe to bring down the router? So I save these changes and say DSR maint and OSPF bug fixed, initiate change analysis. Now the same process is happening. Batfish is comprehensively analyzing the difference along these categories. So in this case, since I changed the configuration, this difference shows up here. So that's as expected. I can look at how my ribs have changed in the network. And more importantly, I can look at how my end-to-end reachability has changed. So currently the comparison is happening between my second proposed snapshot and my first proposed snapshot. So a lot of flows that I had lost are now added between the two snapshots. But what I really care about is whether for my original snapshot and my second proposal, is that safe or not? So now this is your money shot. What this is showing is that if you were to apply both of those changes, bring the router down, as well as fix the OSPF bug, this change is safe because no flow is losing connectivity and no additional flows is realized. And that gives you a very strong guarantee that these changes are safe to push to the network. So hopefully you found this demo and these capabilities interesting. Stay tuned for additional demos. And in the meanwhile, feel free to reach us on Slack or GitHub. Thank you.